the reparations conversation is a much needed conversation, and I'm so grateful that when Joe Biden is elected, we will have that in a formalized way at the national level.
As a final note to Black people in America, you mentioned your ancestors who, you know, were descendants of enslaved Black people. Reparations and sort of giving Black people what we deserve. You know, so much has been taken from us. And I think of Atlanta as a thriving place where Black people have achieved despite all that's been taken. What would you like to see happen to give Black people equal footing when it comes to business, when it comes to, you know, achieving our dreams in this country? What do you think that actually looks like, whether it's from a local level in Atlanta or on a national level?
So it was really interesting when the protest started. I remember my 18-year-old saying to me, this isn't about Black and white, this is about rich and poor. And I think that really is highlighted in Atlanta because African Americans have achieved a lot by and large, but there is still the largest income equality gap in any city right here in Atlanta. So there is still this divide that is so wide that we're still struggling to address in our city. I think the reparations conversation is a much needed conversation, and I'm so grateful that when Joe Biden is elected, we will have that in a formalized way at the national level. And again, it's about this not being a moment, this is about a movement. And finally, this acknowledgement that there needs to be a study of reparations in America. But I think on top of that, we've got to do across this country what we are doing in Atlanta, that there are inequities that exist in our cities, and then putting policies behind it to close that gap. Because, and it's interesting, I was looking through my Biden book yesterday, and I had a note in here. I don't even know the context of when I wrote this down. It said, the child who is not embraced by the whole village will burn it down to feel its warmth. African proverb. And that's what we're seeing happening across this country. People are feeling left out. They're tired of having their noses pressed against the window pane, looking in, and the frustration is boiling over, and it's an obligation that we all have to make sure we're doing all we can do to close the divide in our community.